Hi everyone, we are going to be talking about alpha-beta pruning now. And in case you haven't checked out the Minimax algorithm, that's a prerequisite for this. So I suggest you check that in the description below. Alpha-beta pruning, like the name suggests, is basically cutting the parts of a tree which you don't need. And the tree that we are talking about, of course, is a game tree. So this represents all the possible states that you can play in a game. So as the Minimax algorithm states, what we do is we go to the start node, and it's the blue player playing first. So they can play three moves, as these arrows show, which then comes to the red player. So all of these three moves are played, and these three possibilities are then given to the red player, who can make moves from those possibilities. So you see that on the very first one, there are three possible branches. So red can play three moves in this position, which give finally values over here. So these values, normally they represent a terminal node in a Minimax algorithm, but you could use heuristics to understand what is the value of a position. So we'll have heuristics in a separate video. For now, just understand that if given a board position, you want a rough estimate of what is happening. So if it's a positive score, then the first player is winning. If it's a negative score, then the second player is winning. Right? This is usually with two player games only. So you see plus 30, plus 25, plus 55. So the first player is winning in all three conditions, all three moves that red can play here. But red's job is to minimize the score, because they want to take it behind the integer line as much as possible. That's what they want. They want negative scores, or at least low scores, so that red wins by small margins, if at all. So amongst these three, 25 will be chosen, right? So now let's just do this according to the Minimax algorithm, as we have explained. So 25, we come here, plus 10 is the only possible value. We come here, it's still not evaluated entirely, so we come here. Blue tries to maximize the score, so it's plus 10. Plus 10 and plus 500 minimize the score here, which is plus 10. And amongst these three, you maximize the score, which is plus 25 right here. Alright. So we have the required tree. Now, when we did this evaluation, you saw that we went through each and every node and then expanded them, probably ran heuristics on these nodes. And understand that when you're playing a game like chess, or a game which is a little complicated to evaluate, these nodes, these terminal nodes, are actually very expensive. So you probably check for any checkmates, you check for whether your king is in check, etc., etc., and that's how you get to the evaluation function. So what you want to be doing is saving on, you know, evaluating the cost of these nodes. This probably means white is winning. That's why plus 500 is a pretty big score. So well, you want to reduce the number of evaluations, and you also want to reduce the number of branching. Why? Well, because have a look at this. Let's say you have a branching factor of B and a depth of D that you're going to. Alright, so branching factor, let's say, is 5, or let's keep it simple, 8. And D is 5. Alright? So these are the number of computations that you're making. A reasonable number. What if I can reduce your branching factor by half? Right, 50% savings per branching factor. So that is 4. And still you're going down to the same depth. So that would be raised to the power 5. This number is equal to 2 raised to the power 10, which is 1024. While this number is equal to 2 raised to the power 15, which in turn is equal to 32,000. Alright? More than 32,000. Basically, 32 times of this number. So you're making savings of about, what, 96%. If you're able to reduce the branching factor by 50%. Now, mind you, 50% is a huge saving, and through alpha beta, you probably won't be getting that. This is when you have a perfect heuristic. But reasonable savings are around 25% of the branching factor, and that itself is huge. So the top programs in AI contests, which are using the Minimax approach, always use alpha beta or some variation of that. So this is a very, very important algorithm to know about. Alright, so let's understand what it is. Well, alpha-beta pruning says that if a node can mathematically be proven to never need to be evaluated, then don't evaluate it. Basically, if you don't need to do something, don't do it. Alright? And it uses two parameters for that. One is alpha, and the other one is beta. Alpha means what is the minimum amount that I can take. So this is concerning the first player. The first player is always trying to maximize their score. That's why they think about what is the minimum that I can take. Alright? The second player thinks about what is the maximum that I have to give. This is, remember, the second player is minimizing. So they are thinking about their worst case scenario. What is the maximum that I need to give away? And similarly, of course, like we said, the first player is thinking about their worst case scenario. What is the minimum that I can take? Using these two parameters, we are going to be making decisions which will help us save on evaluating nodes. Alright, let's see how. Firstly, alpha and beta are going to be set in the start node. So, these are the two parameters that you have. And initially, what is the minimum that you can take? Nothing. You can't take anything, you're not sure about anything. So, nothing or the worst, like negative infinity is what we're talking about. So, this is what that is. What about beta? What is the maximum that you have to give in the worst case? Everything. So, that is positive infinity for us. Right? So this makes sense because if you're the first player, you're not sure what you're going to get. You say, I'm going to get absolutely nothing. And if you're the second player, you say, I'm not sure. In the worst case, I may have to give everything away. So that's what this these values mean. Now, like in a typical DFS, we come to the left of the root node, first child. All right, alpha and beta are passed on to the children, always. So alpha is negative infinity, beta is positive infinity. We come to this node, which says plus 30. So it's a terminal node, it's evaluated. Both its alpha and beta parameters are set. Now this node is evaluated and sent to the parent. Alright, so plus 30 is sent to this node, which is a minimizing node. It's the second player's turn. So the second player looks at it like this way. They are going to be playing around with beta. Now, let's represent beta on the integer line. Right, this is 0, this is negative infinity, this is positive infinity. Currently, we are over here. The second player says, I'm getting an offer to take plus 30. And my job is to push my evaluation as far behind as I can to the negative numbers. So I'm getting a plus 30. And plus infinity is what I have right now. I'm going to take the plus 30 because it's better than what I have right now. So beta says, okay, plus 30. And then it starts evaluating this node. This is the second player's second choice. Plus 25 is what's being offered. Again, alpha and beta are set over here and sent back to the parent. The parent looks at plus 25, which is over here, and says that, okay, I'm getting a value even further towards the negative numbers than the value that I have right now, plus 30. So I'll take it. Plus 25 is what beta is set to. Remember, nothing happens to alpha because it's the second player's turn and the second player only works with beta, the maximum that you need to give. Alright, we come to the third node, which is plus 55. Plus 55 is somewhere over here. And the second player says, okay, I mean, once it's sent back, the value sent back, it says, I have a value better than the value you're offering, so no thank you, I'm going to keep it, I'm going to keep plus 25 and evaluate further nodes if there are. Right? So no change in beta here. While here you returned a value of plus 55. So this was redundant, but okay, we had to evaluate it. Fine. Now all children are evaluated and the minimum is chosen, plus 25, which is then sent back to the parent node. This node, remember, works only with alpha, the minimum that it can take. But it's not entirely evaluated. However, beta is plus 25. What about alpha? If you look at alpha's line, I'll draw it over here. This is 0. Currently, you're at negative infinity, which is somewhere over here. You want to take the maximum possible. You're getting somewhere, something like negative infinity and an offer of plus 25, which is over here. Right? Of course, it's your job as the first player to make the evaluation as positive as you can. So you're getting something on the right side, you take it. And alpha is set to plus 25. What this logically means is that the first player will not accept a score which is less than or equal to 25 after this. Any score, I mean, it's like going to a market and trying to buy some stuff. You know, you have an offer of 25 rupees. The next offer does not matter. If it's above 25, you won't take it. You don't care. Alright? Anything less than 25 and you will be interested. So, that's what's going to happen. We come here. Now it's again the second player's turn. And just one choice. So we come here. Alpha and beta set to 10. Return to the parent. What are the alpha and beta parameters passed here? Alpha is now positive 25. And beta? Beta isn't positive 25 now. Beta is still positive infinity. Because that's what the parent knows. The parent did not modify beta. It just passed on those parameters. Alright? So we have come here, we got a 10. Beta now becomes plus 10 because that's better than plus infinity. And now something interesting happens. You see, alpha is the minimum that you're taking. So let's draw the integer line over here. Alpha is plus 25, which is this value, plus 25. And beta is plus 10, which is behind it, actually. Plus 10. So the minimum that you're willing to take is more than the maximum that the other person is willing to give. Both players are playing optimally, so this position can never occur. This will never happen. You want more than the other person is ready to give. And that only happens when a position is impossible, when two players are playing optimally and, you know, all the maths is still working. So this node will not be evaluated further. And what are we going to do? Well, we are going to return whatever value we got right now. So plus 25 is what you're going to return. Alpha is what you're going to return. Right? In fact, you could return alpha, you could return plus 25 saying that there's nothing better than 25. But even better, you could return plus 10. Right? Because alpha will not be modified because of that. We'll see that right now. So this node evaluates to plus 10. You return plus 10 here. Plus 10 is somewhere over here. And the first player says, no thank you. I have something even more to the right of it, so I'm not going to take it. I'm going to go here. Alright. Now we have come here. Following the DFS fashion, we come here. And we see minus 20. So I keep forgetting to pass the alpha and beta parameters, but that's what they are. Alpha is still plus 25. Beta is plus infinity. Alright, and here it is alpha is plus 25. Beta is positive infinity. Okay, so minus 20 is what we have here. Alpha beta parameters are set to minus 20. Return to parent. The parent is a maximizing node, so it's going to play only with alpha. You're offering minus 20, which is somewhere over here. So now it's not going to take that at all. So this node is chucked. And alpha and beta parameters are still the same. We come here, it's equal to plus 10. So when you send it here, again, alpha is greater than plus 10. So that's this scenario, plus 10 and plus 25. So that will not be taken. This node is still plus 25. You return to the parent, which sees plus 25, and says, okay, positive infinity was what I had to give. I'm trying to minimize, so I'm going to take the plus 25. And beta set to plus 25. Now there's something interesting happening here. What does this scenario tell you? The minimum that I can take is plus 25. the maximum that they are willing to give is plus 25. So do I need to evaluate any more nodes? No, not really, because in the integer line, you're saying anything beyond this and I'm happy. The other player is saying anything beyond this on the left side and they are happy. So there's only one value which is satisfying it, 25. Do you need to evaluate this node of plus 500? No. Because it's a single point and you know what the evaluation is. So you return that to the parent now. Alright. So the parent sees a value of plus 25 coming in. This node is evaluated at plus 25. Returned. Alpha needs to be updated if at all. Plus 25 is not greater than plus 25. So you don't even update that. Final evaluation is plus 25. Alright, and let's just run the minimax to check if this is correct. So we come here, the maximum possible plus 25, yeah, because they're trying to minimize. Plus 10 is the only value. Yeah, trying to maximize. Okay, that's so this would have been in the minimax algorithm, this would have been plus 10. Alright, and this would have been plus 10 again in the minimax algorithm. These are all fine. So we have plus 10, and plus 25. It's still plus 25. So you see that the math worked out, but even more importantly, logically, we are actually setting bounds on the first player and the second player. The first player will always take more if they have a choice, and the second player will always give less if they have a choice. That's what these two parameters of alpha beta mean, and recursively this function works out very well. So that's it, yeah. If you want to know what are the average percentage of savings that you have in alpha beta in a contest, it's around 25% if you have a good heuristic. So if you don't have a good heuristic and you think your heuristic sucks, then you could try a different approach, an entirely different approach like Monte Carlo tree search or something. But if you have 25% savings, and let's say you're going up to a branch of 7, with branching back to 8, that turns out to be 6 raised to the power 7, because 25% savings, 2 raised to the power 21, which is 2 million, is what you have here, which turns into, which is about 3 into 10 raised to the power 5. So that's about 85% savings, which is huge. And if that can allow you to go for an extra depth, then, you know, if your programs go for an extra depth, they get much, much stronger. So the number of opponents that you start beating are much larger, of course. And this is one of the best algorithms which can really help the strength of your program with probably the minimum effort. If you look at the returns divided by the effort, this is probably the best algorithm after Minimax that you can do. And that's it, that's alpha beta. So use it in the next AI contest, and in case you want notifications for further videos, you could subscribe. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. I'll be happy to help. See you next time.